Hey, Sushan, I was gonna get some pizza, but the whiskey. The whiskey is still in me, so I'm not driving until that wears off. I found this video in my YouTube recommendations. They Hate Us, Sad. Storytelling Ron. This guy sounds familiar to me, like I seen him before. Anyway, I thought I would just watch this blind. What the heck? He's got weapons in his room and a helmet. Oh my. And he's got TNT 5th edition books. Why? Why? Very strange. Did people just skip? They went from 3.5 to 5? Not many people did the D&D 4 for some reason. Why? Why is that? Is it like Traveler? Not many people did Traveler 4. They did the new era, Traveler 3, the new era. Maybe they stumbled into GURPS Traveler for a bit, but then they all went to Traveler 5. Like, Traveler 4 just got ignored. Game, was it Empire Games back in 94? Or was it 90? No, it was 96, I think, when Traveler 4 came out. No one, it's like no one asked for it. I remember $49.95 for the imitation leather hardcover book of Traveler 4. And it was signed by Mark Miller, and it was in a game store. But it had been used, like someone ran the game a few times with that book in the game store. So it was like the pages were all dog-eared and stuff. Otherwise, maybe I would have bought it. It looked better than newsprint. The cheaper edition, the cheaper printing of that book was on newsprint. I want to say New Era was on newsprint as well. Anyway, why you need to leave D&D? Others. What is he going to talk about? I'm curious.
Hello, storytellers. It's Storytelling Ron, and this video is about this. Why you need to leave D&D and others. Now, I don't hate D&D, the original Dungeons & Dragons. I don't hate role-playing games. But still, nonetheless, I'm just going to talk about this. And, you know, I still hope I play other role-playing games, but I'm really...
He's using a real camera, not like me. I'm using a fake-ass webcam, but he's using a real-ass camera. You can tell by the depth of field going on there.
Really loving what For the Lore RPG is doing for me, and I gotta share it with all of you. So what is it, what are some open G?
hang on, what's he doing? He's using 30 frames. That's cool. For some reason it looked like he was recording at 60 frames.
GL debacle. There are lies after it. I want this to fit on here.
This isn't going to look like a Total Party Skills character sheet when he's done with it, will it?
I really want to say debacle. Let me just make this a little small.
Yeah, I've been using Traveler's rules to play in the... total party skills setting. I've been using Traveler to play in, to get some play ideas from that.
29. 29. Why not? They're lies. They tried to lie about it. Draft. I'm just going to put that in there. Draft. Yeah, right. What else did they lie about? Or do or whatever. Oh, God.
Oh, was he talking about WotC or Hasbro lying, or the players lying, or the Twitterverse lying about the players that are lying about the producers? You got the producers, and then you have the takers. If you're not a producer, you're a taker, right? Go to Walmart. People either have jobs and they're buying stuff at Walmart, or they don't have jobs and they're stealing from Walmart. You got those two things going on in commerce.
Kevin Bink, Brink, no white men, which is a code word for Christians, so no Christians. June Pride.
Well, the no white thing, that kind of falls into Western Civ, I guess. Nords. Pick your epoch. You got Vikings, Europeans. Majority are kind of white-ish in color. They don't have the dominant black, dark brownish skin tones yet. Redhead, blonde-haired, you know, that kind of thing. Wasp. On the East Coast, they'd be called wasps if they were Protestants. Yeah, I guess you don't want any of those. Vermont's doing something crazy lately. I can't remember what. I heard on the news and I could not believe it. I'm not, no way in hell would I ever move to Vermont. From what I hear, tell is going on there in the last month and a half. But they're doing something ridiculous over there. It's like the people that live there are choosing self-suicide, basically, for the next 5 years. God, why would they do that?
Thing. Pride. It. I mean, come on.
Yeah, the pride thing used to be one day, then it became 1 week, then it became 1 month, now it's yearly. Pride is yearly now. Most corporations run this stuff.
They're just terrible. Paizo's the same. Paizo.
Hey, okay. Storytelling run. Corporations all do this. They all do it now. So, pick your poison when you're buying a product. That's all I can recommend.
They're not gonna. They hate Christians or they're against Christianity. They're denying the.
Okay, I know what he's talking about now when he says they hate us. Okay, so he's talking about corporations that hate their own customers. Yeah, the HR departments in these corporations are taken over by communists. And it used to be, you know, 8 years ago, it used to be the old saying, you know, get woke, go broke. Times that by five or six, and that's what we have now with corporations. It's all about the message. As long as the corporation spits out their message, that's all they care about. And when the stockholders become woke, then it will be complete. These companies will fall into oblivion. The shareholders, the stockholders, whatever you call them, they're going to lose everything when these corporations fall. They'll go down with the corporation. Because what are you going to buy? Let's say Apple decides to do something stupid, which they will. The shareholders want to sell their stock while Apple tumbles. What are they going to buy? What will they put their money into? Because the shareholders want to get rich. They just want to be rich. Where are they going to put their money into? Because everything is woke now, pretty much, if it's a corporation with more than... with more than 250 employees, it's pretty much woke. What are they going to do? Everything they put their money into is going to fail. What are they going to do? Not invest? Not invest in anything? That only makes things even worse. Can't wait. I can't wait for this. Since I was 22, I've been longing to live in the age of Road Warrior. And now we're seeing it. We're seeing the beginnings of Mad Max. So in 8 years from now, oh, it will be marvelous. It will be marvelous.
D&D was created by Christians, by Christendom. Role-playing games and war games were created by Christians. No, Christians here in America, just like basketball, just like.
Generally, the entertainment industry is made by the Jews. Everything else is made by the Christians. Going to the moon. Christians. Go to SpaceX or Tesla. Look at the engineers. Look at the designers. Look at the people that are producers in that orchestration. Christians. Not crazy, psychotic people.
Like romance, just like chivalry, just like football, soccer. Christians created all this stuff that we love and adore today.
The Boy Scouts. What happened to the Boy Scouts? Oh, that's right. The Democrats ruined it. You have to be gay now to be in the Boy Scouts. So what happens? No one signs up for the Boy Scouts except for the gay people. So that's what happened to the Boy Scouts. All the nice things are gone now.
Movies. Well, Jews, but Christians started the camera stuff.
Now, superheroes came from the Jews. What else did they do? Christmas songs. All the Christmas, pretty much all the Christmas songs that Christians sing that were written in the 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s were written by Jews. Like, let's make money. Let's write Christmas songs and sell records. And Jews and Christians, I mean, one can argue that they have nothing in common. Some would say, what's the term that they use? Judeo-Christian. Some people say it's made up. It doesn't exist. That's an American thing. A recent American thing. Judeo-Christian. To me, it just boils down, simplifies that Jews and Christians worship the same God. That's all. And have the same values, pretty much. They share the same values. They root for each other. When there's a World War II going on, both Jews and Christians go into war together to fight evil. The Greatest Generation did some things like blew up Germany, blew up Japan. Those two countries are still, to this day, pretty much they adhere to the rules of the land set by white Christians, pretty much. They haven't really diverged much from that setting they were given back in the 40s. The Greatest Generation did that. Later generations got involved with Korea and Vietnam and Iraq and Kosovo, Serbia, you know, whatever. Croatia. What was that one place called? I can't remember now. Anyway, I didn't follow much of what the army was doing in the 90s. So forgive me. But all of those places weren't handled by the Greatest Generation. They were handled by the generation after. Maybe two generations after. And they were piss poor. That generation was piss poor. Where are we now? We got North Korea to deal with. We've got Iraq to deal with. All that fighting in Iraq for what? For nothing. We just We just pussied and left. So I was like, what a waste. What a waste of time. What a waste of men. But that's what the U.S. government's for now, is to kill off all the good men in this country. Just send them off to war and have them murdered for no reason. And for what? It's like, it's crazy. Crazy, crazy. Because communists would prefer that everything on planet Earth be covered over with torture chambers and concentration camps. That's the communist goal. The Democrats side with the communists at every turn. And then the Republicans side with the Democrats every chance they get. So the Republicans and the Democrats are both crapola.
So give me a break. Why do you need to leave D&D? Stop supporting stuff that just doesn't have the Bible as their source, their foundation.
I stopped supporting Mongoose Traveler because Mongoose Publishing is woke as hell. The last two books I bought from them were gay as hell.
Foundation. Okay. And then now what they got? They got the freaking... Oh, and then they had that D&D summit, which I found, lame. not for me, but for people that went, that was interestingly lame. I remember Perk.
What did those losers think they would get out of going to a summit? What were they hoping for? Why would they even go? Just so they can be influencers on YouTube? What a shit show that was. Everyone knows what garbage tier storytelling was involved there.
Perkins, I think, I don't know who the dude was, the bald guy. Is it Perkins? Perkins?
Perkins.
Just atheist.
Chris Perkins.
Proud. Like, he was so above them all, above gods. He said, gods are too needy. Okay, mister, I guess you're controlling your own heart rate. Good luck with that. I don't know. I just don't like these people.
I want to say Gygax was Catholic. The guy who wrote Lord of the Rings was Catholic, right? Or not sure. Was he on the fence? C.S. Lewis, the guy who wrote Narnia, I think he was Catholic. Anyway.
I don't like them. I don't need to like them. I don't care if they're in D&D or doing D&D things, or I'm using some of their products, and they were fun or are fun. I don't know, but at the same time, I had to redo them anyway. So I don't want to play.
Well, since second edition, all DMs do is homebrew, house rule their D&D games. Me and Samwise Seven, he loves to homebrew any game he buys. Any game he buys or is given, first thing he wants to do is homebrew it. House rule. Do the house rules. He says in his videos that he loves changing core rules of games that he buys. Me, if I don't like the rules in a game, I'm not going to buy the game. Now, if I know that the guy who wrote or the girl who wrote the game hates me, I'm not going to buy the game. I mean, I'm not going to give money to crazy people.
Anymore. I don't want to give them my money. And I don't think you should be giving their money either. We need to, and I don't think you should draw your kids to them. It's one of the biggest issues. If you want to play it, fine. But then are you going to really draw your kids to Dungeons and Dragons? And then they're going to go want to play Dungeons.
Yeah, don't take your kids to Disney movies. They've ruined Star Wars. They've ruined the Marvel comics. Feminized everything. That's why I buy old movies on DVD for future generations. Have kids watch old movies like Raiders of the Lost Ark, the old Star Wars from the 70s and 80s. Show them the cool movies that were made in the 50s, 60s, 70s, early 80s that still stand up to this day. Showing a child now movies that are currently coming out, what was the one movie that came out last year that was any good? Maverick? That was it. That's the only fucking movie that came out last year worth a hill of beans. Maybe Dune. Don't show your kids any movie from last year or from this year. Because that's just child abuse. I mean, what are you doing? What are you doing to your kids by showing them current films?
Dragons, that we're going to go be part of the world that wants to corrupt Christianity, wants to change it, wants to make sure, force us to believe in homosexuality, force us to believe in the transgendering and the butchering of our children, or the sacrifice of our children. Both, butchering and sacrifice of our children. That's what they want us to believe in.
Well, in California, the goal is to kill 4,000 babies a week. Right now, it's only 1,000 babies a week. Because the state gets money. They make money. Hospitals make money killing babies. It's an industry. The state doesn't want to hear that women are deciding not to kill their child, their children. So they want to promote the opposite of that. They have pills now. Women can take pills now to kill their own babies. They don't even have to go to an abortion clinic now. They just do it at home. Like I said before, this is the beginning of the beginning that we're in. Some say, oh, may you live in interesting times. Well, this is beyond interesting at this point.
So I am offering a game, a role-playing game.
Ooh.
This is completely available right now on storytellingron.com for free. Just sign up, download it. It's the full game. Look at the rules. The rules are freaking like 5 pages. I mean,
whatever. 5 pages.
So here's the rules. Here's the weapons and the.
I've looked at in the last half day or two. I've looked at rules that are only less than 20 pages. Is that a trend now or something? Since this OGL thing happened, all of a sudden I'm finding downloads from Google's site Google Docs or whatever, that you role play rules that are less than 20 pages. Some of them are good, some of them are just D&D renditions. What's this one? Is this one another D&D thing, or is it something unique? I see all kinds of dice here. That's kind of cool.
The armor and the gear. And you don't even need to look at these rules unless you want to.
Yeah, I was going to say, this is more a reference sheet looking stuff here.
And then here's one, combat and actions. This is all combat. Plus,
order of combat. In general, is it? Players should go quickly, but here are some guidelines. Compare the. I don't see an initiative roll. Is that interesting or what? Or am I missing it? The ones, okay, so there are critical rolls. There's D20 rolls here. Interesting.
Plus, it's got not even one, two pages. This is denouement. So it's not even in combat. It's the you know, this is the combat, how it works. And I've been playing DMing for 45 years. Game mechanics.
I'll take a look at it. It looks interesting. In my games, I don't use combat rounds, but I do use rounds. I want to say there's always, during a game session of mine, it's always in rounds. There's always rounds going on. Not combat rounds, just rounds. In a round, you just say where you're at and what you're doing. There could be combat. You could be doing a combat thing, or you could be doing an exploration thing, or you could be doing a repair thing. So I don't use combat rounds in my game. Because I pick game systems that are skill-based.
This is just the different game rules and stuff that help you play the game, especially the die roll, die ranks and die rank results. These are the two main ones right here. And the rest of these are just suggestions and options.
So your die type changes depending on your rank. That's similar to, I want to say, Savage Worlds and the Serenity role-playing game, which I'm a fan of.
So Power Prayer is a big game mechanic. And then, okay, so this is for dying conditions and, you know, vitality, which is hit points and wounds.
Dying. Okay, so how do you die in this game? Let's see. So vitality, if it reaches zero, grievous runes, for every wound one has, there are plenty of die ranks. Negative vitality, how far negative can you go before you die? Oh, so if your vitality reaches the full negative of your vitality, they have passed. So let's say if your vitality is 14, if you're at minus 14, you're dead. Don't know if I like that. I like it when you don't have health points at all. No hit points. I'm not a fan of hit points.
And then life saves. And wounds are, you know, you're at minus D4, minus D6, minus D8, until you get really healed. And if you go to past minus D12, you're dead. Plus, there's if you go below zero, you also could die too. Okay? And then here is the, you know, spell casting, but it's blessings using faith. And this is the rules for that. And here's the list of all the blessings. And they're all expandable based on just how many faith points you use. Put into them, and faith points just equals your wisdom. You know, like, you know, in here it's called spirit. So if you have four, then you get four faith points, and you can obviously upgrade those faith points to get more. And the more you spend, the stronger the blessing is. And there's a risk in spending too much too quickly. The glory points is going up levels, which is just glory points, and these are all the things that are upgradable. These are all the things that are upgradable on the character, and then you can come up with anything else. Skills is totally open. It's whatever you want to come up with for skills, the character, as you play the game. So you may start off as a warrior, but you may go towards paladin, or you may go towards bard, you know, if you want, or you may go towards a smith. It's just a matter of you role-playing it, though, and maybe going and getting smithing tools, or learning from the local smith, and just describe.
That's how I do Skyrim. Whatever I've been doing in my Skyrim currently, when it asks me to level up something, I try to pick from what I've been doing recently in the game that would make sense. You know, you don't want to be a thief. You're doing thief stuff, and then when you level up, you put points in your healing ability or your barbarian stuff activities. That doesn't make sense if you've been doing thievery for the last, I don't know, 2 weeks of gameplay.
Describing that, and James goes, okay, cool. You can now add smith to your skills and upgrade that as you go along. And then you got smithing tools, and you can start using it. And it's just a matter of rolling above a certain number and getting extra bonuses and or repairing things.
Looking at his little characters here with the big old cartoon eyeballs. Interesting.
Very.
I need to change the artwork in my book. Now that the AI has gotten better, I can use better AI now in my artwork for my book.
Simple game system. That's it. I'm done. I mean, the rest of this is GM stuff. Okay? Making names, the pagan culture.
Yeah, GM stuff. Making maps, making cities, random tables, that kind of stuff.
And some other, you know, adventures in Bestry.
Is the book in landscape format? I'm asking. Maybe it's the way he's viewed his layout page, you know, adjacent pages next to each other, that kind of thing. That would be interesting, though, if the book was in landscape format instead of portrait.
Street. Examples, and that's it, man. It's very simple. There's no level limits. There's no XP except the glory points. There's just starting points for characters, but after that, you can kind of go where you want. You start off with a +5 plus these right here, plus these and these traits.
Yeah, is it point by, and you just put in points in your things? I'm old school, so I like to roll random dice to get those values.
+5. Let's say you're a warrior. +5, +3, +1, 0, -1, -2. Done.
Okay, so he gives you the numbers, then you choose where they go. That's kind of like a point buy.
And you can upgrade those, too, with glory points. And your weapons are very simple. It's just a hit, which is based off your aggression for melee stuff and your awareness for aim for bows. Damage is very similar to D&D, like D6 for a sword. You know.
So it uses D&D, what do they call it? D&D physics. So you got the two hit, you have to do the two hit thing. I'm not a fan of two hit rolls. This is a good start, though. I like it. I like it. It's a good take on what's currently happening in the RPG realm.
I can go to and you can upgrade that. You can actually spend a glory point to make that D6 go to a D8, to a D10, D12. Okay, I do fighting. My combat in this feels what I have experienced in my medieval armored combat. And you have to be in it to know it. You have to get the bruises, the injuries, snapped ACLs to understand what combat is like. In medieval armor with steel weapons, you gotta feel it and know it. You gotta break that glass ceiling, whatever. But also, I know gameplay, so I've married those two together to create what I believe is the best representation I like for combat. So you got two hit, you got damage, you got a burden, which is and that's here's how encumbrance works on mine. You can carry two heavy things, three medium and four light. And if you go above and more than that, you know, -D4. Or your armor save. Your armor save is also your burden penalty because obviously if you have a high armor save, like a D12, which is like full on plate, then if you have too much items, you get -D12 to all your rolls. Also the armor save is if you...
Yeah, I'm going to subscribe to this guy. What the heck? Maybe I'll remember him if I look at other videos of his. He seems familiar, like I've... Maybe I've argued with him in the past. It's possible.
going on treacherous terrain, you know, or muddy or swampy, you had a minus d12 because if you're in full plate. So I kept it that simple. I don't know if I put it in the Dark Ages one, the print version, but that's the new rule. It gives you an option to do minus d4. Yeah, usually a d4. Oh, so I'm going to change it right now because I have it in the other ones, but not in this one. Usually d4.
I want to know what that book is in front of his D&D books. This one right here. Because normally the book you put in front of your D&D book is the one you actually use mostly for roleplay. And I can't tell what that even is. Looks familiar. Looks like something I should recognize right away.
Or your armor save, whichever. I'll just put or your armor save. That's really it. And I have an ongoing errata page, which let me grab right now. Where is it? With these fixes, and I'm going to make sure I keep this ongoing. I'm doing it live, not live, but right here on video.
Live.
just minor little things that
I've done programming live. I get all the Python people watching those vids.
Fixing up here, right there. And I put them in bold, whatever I've changed. Okay. Done with that list. Okay, so. What was I talking about? The armor save?
I use Scrivener to write in, but Scrivener is kind of different because when I create the PDF, it looks way different than what I see on my screen. So it's not WYSIWYG. If Scrivener was WYSIWYG, that would be so awesome. So what I type and what I see on the screen is exactly how it formats in the PDF. So maybe I'll give LibreOffice or whatever it's called, OpenOffice, one of those two, a try writing a book in one of those things. But Scrivener is just, it does everything else better. It's just the formatting. It doesn't do very well. You're supposed to use something else to do your formatting with, but use Scrivener to do the writing in.
I don't even know what I'm talking about now. Oh, here, armor save.
How'd you get those arrows? Is that like another layer? Just asking. I'm guessing these are layers, graphic layers, on top of what's already there.
So if you for gear, your defense is like your armor class, sort of, based on my experience in combat. Your defense is your awareness. It starts off with a 12 plus your awareness. Let's say I have a plus 3 in there because I did the warrior thing, plus 5, plus 3, plus 1. So that would be a 15 defense. And I get a shield, which is plus 2, so that's 17. Then I wear a great helm, which is plus 2, so it's a 19. So I have a 19 defense. Now that doesn't have to do with your plate mail. It has to do with what I just said there: the awareness, a shield, a helm. If you get those,
awareness is like perception. So when you put the helmet on, you still need to have a good field of view, because the helmet's going to block some of that peripheral vision, right? But you need to be aware of your surroundings while you're all armored up. That makes sense.
And remember, the shield and helm are part of your burden, so you can only carry so much. And then your armor save is, say, I'm wearing full plate, which in the Dark Ages one is not really there, but I'm just going to use full plate. They have Brigadine, which is...
Okay, so... Is he going to talk about the game still or something else? What is that? That looks familiar. What is this? He has a space version?
Our Christian faith into the game. But they can certainly bring in their ideology, their religion of LGBTQT and transgenderism and all that. Their love is love, which is not what love is. Love is sacrifice. Love is what God did for us. We are just selfish, self-centered. Love is
self-absorbed. not self-aware, self-centered, self-absorbed, self-conscious. Yeah, but not self-aware.
We desire our own lusts. Love is lust is what they're saying. Anyway, well, yeah, I wanted to have this happy dappy D&D channel where I was doing Dungeons and Dragons, and I taught my daughter Dungeons and Dragons and my family, and we played and I did Star Wars RPG, and it turns out that they hate me.
Don't send your kid to school. Homeschool instead. Otherwise, you're just your kid will become a zombie and turn against you. That's what that's what happened to kids in 1984. That's what Hitler did for the Hitler Youth. Yeah, don't send your kids to those things.
Okay. So that's why I'm doing this. I'm not doing this because I wanted to do it. I'm doing it because I was... They hate me. And,
okay, I gotta watch more of his videos.